Is Scratch dying? Scratch has been the default program for beginners for almost a decade. It's been praised for introducing kids to coding concepts with its drag and drop system. But is this popular platform slowly losing its edge? Scratch is starting to decline in popularity. While Scratch is great for teaching the basics of coding, it really hasn't evolved to meet the needs of more advanced learners. And let's be honest, once you've mastered the basics and fundamentals of Scratch, its limited capabilities can really hold you back. Scratch is not designed at all for professional level games, or even for serious game developers. The blocks are fun, but they're also restricting when you're ready to learn more. Scratch might seem like it has endless possibilities for the beginners, but once you start to learn Scratch, there's actually quite a bunch of weird limits and restrictions. One restriction that I think is really dumb is the clone limit. In Scratch, you have the ability to clone or to create copies of a sprite. This is great, but there's a limit to how much clones you can create, and that's 300. Beginners might never reach this random limit, but once you actually start trying to create advanced projects, you're going to be held back by this restriction. Modern computers are fast enough that they can handle way more than 300 clones, but for some strange reason, Scratch finds the need to make this random and arbitrary limit. Another restriction that Scratch has is its performance. You see, the Scratch editor runs at 30 frames per second. 30 FPS! Now, that might not seem like that much of a big deal for the non-gamers out there, but just hear me out. This is a video of me hitting a clip in Fortnite at 60 frames per second. And now, here's the same clip, but at 30 frames per second. If you didn't notice the difference, I suggest that you take a trip to the nearest eye doctor because you're blind. But if you did see the difference, then you can see the issue. This low frame rate on Scratch projects makes a huge restriction for fast-paced projects that need precision timing. It's hard to slice a fruit in Fruit Ninja if the project's running slower than a turtle. There should at least be an option to change the FPS to something other than 30, like 60 for example. Turbo Warp and Gandhi have this option to change the FPS, but somehow, Scratch doesn't. Another limitation is Scratch's terrible optimizations. In Scratch's programming, it pauses for a few milliseconds between running each block of code. This makes projects slow and clunky if you have a lot of blocks. Luckily, you can run Scratch projects without any lag, with websites like Turbo Warp, Gandhi, and PenguinMod. These are mods of Scratch that compile Scratch into JavaScript, which reduces the lag to almost nothing. Sadly, if you use Scratch, you aren't able to use your full creative potential that you could with engines like Unity, Godot, or Unreal Engine. Projects like these are not possible in Scratch. The limits of Scratch, but no, there's more. Scratch's screen size is limited to 480 by 360 pixels. That is tiny. Most modern monitors have a resolution of 1920 by 1080 pixels. For comparison, here's the Scratch resolution on a screen of that size. This small resolution means that even if you spend a week drawing a high resolution player character, once you import it into Scratch, it's gonna look like garbage. All of your high resolution art is gonna look terrible and extremely pixelated on Scratch's low resolution. HD? No, we have HD at home. Another option would be to use Vector, which has 0 pixels. But for some strange reason, using vector sprites in Scratch makes it extremely laggy. If only there was an alternative to Scratch that fixed all of these issues. Even in the game development field, Scratch lacks complexity and power that other platforms have. Sure, you can make cool projects, but they're often really basic compared to what you can make with more sophisticated game engines. Just look at Scratch's trending page. Sometimes you might see an exciting and unique project, but the vast majority of Scratch is filled with repetitive junk. Projects that users can spit out in minutes, and this gains popularity like you wouldn't believe. Just think of TikTok, but if TikTok was controlled by 6-year-olds. That's basically what Scratch is in 2024. Luckily, there are alternatives to Scratch, like Gandhi IDE. Unlike Scratch, Gandhi IDE has a much more versatile platform. You have options like the code editor, where you can still drag and drop blocks, but then view what the blocks would look like in Python, in actual scripting languages. They also have a bunch of extensions and plugins on the extension page. Like look at this, they have Python, AI Hub, Text Animator, Achievements and Leaderboards, and even Multiplayer. Along with that, you can also do real-time collaboration, Scratch is not even on the same level as this platform. And sure, Scratch is a fantastic tool for absolute beginners, but it's not aging well. Scratch is eating itself from the inside out with its horrendous moderation. Scratch moderation is always bad. Check out this video where I explain Scratch's moderation system. To sum it up, the moderation system on Scratch is terrible and it sucks. There's no clear rules and guidelines. Scratch's moderation system is like any other social media's moderation, but many times worse. But hey, while Scratch moderation system might leave you frustrated, at least you can feel good by flexing my limited edition Jackson Academy X Osaka hoodie. I designed it for people who desire style and comfort, giving them a 200% increase in aura, while also leveling up their coding skills. Grab yours at jacksonacademy.shop and get it now before it's gone. Anyways, for real though, you can get banned for the most simple misunderstandings, like sharing a YouTube link, which Scratch does not make very clear on their rules and guidelines page. In fact, that's why I was banned from Scratch. At this point, my mind tells me the best way to make a very popular game and not get in trouble by the Scratch team is to make a platformer. The platformer has to be black and have an eye, and the text must be in Japanese or Chinese. I was also temporarily banned on a new account for saying slappers, which I guess was flagged as inappropriate by the automated moderation tool. What's even more frustrating is how these rules are applied to different users. Some high-profile users can receive preferential treatment, such as being allowed to share external links outside of Scratch without facing any penalties. Scratch also favors generic and simplistic games. These rise to the top of the platform's algorithm in favor of high-effort creations. Honestly, Scratch's moderation systems are not only bad, but they also prioritize quantity over quality. Mass-produced projects dominate the platform. Dang, Roblox moderation is getting some competition. So, does this mean that you should ditch Scratch? I don't think so. Scratch is a great starting point, but once you've outgrown it, there's really no reason to stick around when platforms like Gandhi IDE, Unity, Turbo Warp, Penguin Mod, Unreal Engine, and Godot can offer so much more. Scratch is one fantastic tool for beginners, introducing coding concepts in a fun drag-and-drop format, but lately, I've just noticed it hasn't been keeping up with more advanced learners. While it's great for teaching the basics, Scratch holds people back in what people want to take their skills further with. And honestly, why stick around with Scratch's terrible website, with its nonsensical limitations, its dumb rules and moderation, when there's so much better platforms? Once you've outgrown it, moving on to other platforms is the logical next step. Scratch will always be a great tool for beginners, but if you want to take your skills to the next level, it might be time to move on. Wait, before you leave, I'm working on a first-person multiplayer game called Afterblast, and I need your help to beta test it. Wishlist it now on Steam, and also check out the itch.io, where you can play online for free. I need your ideas, suggestions, and I need people to also find bugs, so I'd appreciate it if you left a comment. Thanks for watching, leave a like and subscribe, and I'll see you in another video.